Hey everybody, how you doing? Happy Wednesday, man. We are almost done with the month of April. Man, it's been a long month, but I'll tell you what, the Lord is bringing us through. Hey, I just want to encourage you with some thoughts, and especially want to today challenge those of us that are leaders. In 1 Timothy 3 and 4, we're given some of the prerequisites, some of the requirements for being a leader. I don't know if you ever as a kid played Follow the Leader. Remember that game that we used to play as kids? Maybe you've played it with kids here when you're an adult. But you remember sometimes you would follow up to a point, but you wouldn't do certain things, right? Somebody would do something crazy because they'd want you to lose in the game. Well, unfortunately, it's kind of like that in life, especially as leaders. We'll follow God, but only to a point. And I want to challenge you to think about some of the blind spots. Have you ever driven in a new car, a car that you don't drive? Maybe it's your friend's car, or maybe you're test driving a new car or something like that. And you look to the right and the left and you realize that there are different blind spots than you were used to. Things that you couldn't see coming, things that you didn't know were happening. I want to encourage you to look for the blind spots in your leadership. And not just for leaders, but also those of you out there who don't think you're leaders. But I want to encourage you to know you are a leader somewhere, whether it's in your house, whether it's in your family, wherever it is, you're a leader somewhere. And so some of the blind spots, some of the things you don't realize might be happening in your leadership are warned against in 1 Timothy 3 and 4. Some of those are things like being too authoritative, like acting like you're the boss and only what you say goes. You know, you don't need to micromanage people. You lead them, you love them, and you let God kind of direct them in your life. How about exclusiveness? You know, you can't just say it's my way or the highway, because guess what? Just like going from your house to my house, there's a lot of different roads that we can take to get there. And as a leader, you need to remember that the people who are working next to you, and that's right, I said next to you, not beneath you, those people are going to find lots of different ways to get there. Isn't that okay? Because isn't the end goal to get to the house that you want to get to? So you have the same goal. It doesn't matter if they get there a different way. Don't be exclusive. Don't try to hold them to your way or the highway. Lots of times you'll find out their way is better than your way. How about being greedy? You know what? At the end of the day, you've got to ask yourself as a leader why you do what you do. Are you doing it for Christ? Are you doing it for His kingdom? Are you doing it for a kingdom growth and kingdom expansion? Or are you doing it for yourself because you want to benefit from what's happening? Think about that and be honest with yourself. Sometimes there's a blind spot in our lives that we're being too greedy. Sometimes it's just straight sensualism. There's just a lot of sex out there. There's a lot of stuff from pornography and TV and movies and all kinds of stuff out there. And you need to be honest with yourself. You need to take a good, hard look at yourself. Is that possibly a blind spot in my life? Is that something that I am focusing on and taking my focus off of Christ? How about just not being accountable? You know, as a leader, you need to be accountable. You need to have people in your life who will hold you accountable. You know, my favorite hero of all time in sports is John Wooden, the coach at UCLA. And one of the things that he said, one of the things that he taught in his pyramid of success was that he wanted good, strong assistant coaches who would hold him accountable. He talked about the longtime Louisville coach who started as an assistant under him, Denny Crum, who was not afraid to go to Coach Wooden after he'd won all of his championships and he'd become this big, important guy and tell Coach, you know what, Coach? You're wrong. There's another way to do this. He would hold Coach Wooden accountable. And if someone with all that success can be held accountable, listen, you and I can be held accountable. You need people around you who will lovingly hold you up and say, you know what, I think you're messing up. I think you can do it a different way. And finally, what about just being, you know, rationalizing? You know, sometimes we can make some excuses, can't we? And we could say, well, I'm okay, it's good enough, whatever. You know, as leaders, we need to remember something. Christ didn't go to the cross and go halfway. He went all the way. And as leaders, we can't rationalize and say, you know what, that's good enough. Good enough is good enough. No, God deserves our best. And so wherever you're a leader at, whoever I'm talking to right now, whether it's a leader at home and you're the leader of one grandchild, or whether you're leading a church of thousands, remember, Our God says, keep your eyes open for some blind spots in your life. I pray that whatever ministry God's put you in is blessed and that you have Him first in your life. Hey, have a great day. We'll see you next time.